Happy morning, children. Today we are going to discuss about the fundamental unit of life. When we say the fundamental unit of life, children, we mean that how the life has been made. Okay. So first thing here, the fundamental unit of life is cell. Okay, all the living organisms are made up of cell, either one cell or more than one cell. Okay, so before knowing about it, we must know that how many types of cells are there. So today in this class, I would like to discuss about the types of the cell in the beginning, and then I will discuss further. Okay, so let us start, children. When we consider cell, cell is of two types. Cell is of two types. One is prokaryotic. Prokaryotic cells, and another one is eukaryotic cells. Children, before teaching these two, you need to understand what is this pro and what is this eukaryotes. Prokaryotes. Pro means this, prokaryotes. Pro means primitive. That means the cell which came into existence naturally. Okay. So those are known as prokaryotic cells. And this eukaryotes, eu means advanced. Advanced cells means the cell which came into existence due to evolution, due to change in the variations. Due to this, a new type of cell came into existence known as eukaryotes. Now, children, you need to understand the differences between prokaryotes and eukaryotes. Okay. Can you see this? I am going to discuss that. Okay. Prokaryotes and eukaryotes. Okay, children, the first thing you need to know that in prokaryotic cells, there is no nuclear membrane around the nucleus. Hence, the nuclear region is not well defined. When the nuclear region is not well defined, due to this, the nucleus in prokaryotic cell is not called as nucleus. Rather, they are called as nucleoid. Okay, so due to lack of well-defined nuclear region, lack of well-defined nuclear region, but here in this nuclear region is well defined. Okay, So due to this, the nuclear region is well defined. So it has nucleus. So it has nucleus. But in prokaryotes, due to absence of well-defined nuclear region or due to absence of nuclear garden, it has nucleoid. Okay. Second thing, prokaryotes are generally smaller in size. When we talk about prokaryotes, they are generally smaller in size, but eukaryotes, they are larger in size. Smaller and larger means what? Smaller and larger in the context as compared to one another, they are smaller and larger in size. Okay, now next difference, it contains single chromosome, but eukaryotes, they contain more than one chromosomes. Okay, so this was prokaryotes contain single chromosome, but eukaryotes contain more than one chromosome. Okay, and the most important difference between them, that membrane bound cell organelles are present and membrane bound cell organelles are absent. Children, you have studied about the cell organelles like mitochondria, Golgi bodies, okay, plastids. So these cell organelles are present in eukaryotes, but in the prokaryotes these cell organelles are not present. Why? Because they are not having membranes and all the materials are jumbled up with each other. So that point we write, that membrane bound cell organelles are absent, but in this membrane bound cell organelles are present. Okay, this is all about eukaryotic and prokaryotic cells. Okay, this is all about eukaryotes and prokaryotes. Okay, children, thank you.